DJI just got FCC approval for the Avata 360, and Insta360 just moved up their release date to the 4th of December. Now, there's a ban deadline for the 23rd of December, and both companies are racing to launch the world's first true 360 FPV drone. Now, this isn't just a competition anymore. This is all-out war. What's up, everyone? If you guys have been following the drone world at all over the past few weeks, well, then you'll know that things have gotten a little bit insane. We've got two Chinese tech giants that are racing against each other, racing against the clock, and potentially racing against a US government ban. That could change everything. So here's what's happening. DJI is about to launch the Avata 360. The world's first ever 360 degree FPV drone. And Insta360 was supposed to launch their Antigravity A1 in January 2026. But they've announced they're moving up their release date to December the 4th. And then there's the December the 23rd deadline, where DJI could potentially be banned from selling new products in the US if the government doesn't complete a security review. Now, this is the craziest launch drama I've ever seen in the drone industry. And today I'm breaking down everything that you guys need to know. So let's get right into it. Okay, let me give you a little bit of background because this story is kind of wild. Now, back in August, Insta360 announced the Antigravity A1, designed from the ground up with an integrated 360 camera. This thing was built for 360 video. Now, we've got dual lenses on top and bottom, 8K capture and an immersive FPV goggles, the whole package. And they said it would launch in January 2026. Now, everybody in the drone world was hyped. This is genuinely an innovation, something different in a marketplace that's been dominated by DJI for years. But then out of nowhere, DJI started dropping hints. Leaks started appearing and the FCC listing showed up, and suddenly we're hearing about the DJI Avata 360. Now, DJI's answer to the A1 with a twist. This thing has a rotating camera that can switch between 360 mode and full traditional FPV mode. And here is where it actually gets interesting, because on November the 19th, DJI actually secured FCC approval for the Avata 360. Now that's huge, because it means that they can launch before December 23rd, the deadline when DJI becomes automatically added to the FCC ban list. Only if a government agency completes a security review, and fat chance of that happening. And then 3 days ago, Insta360 dropped a bombshell. They said they're actually releasing on December the 4th, not in January 2026. December the 4th. And if you're just seeing this video now, that's probably today or a couple of days ago. Insta360 just moved their launch day up almost by 2 months just to beat DJI to the market. Now, this is a flat out race. Now, you might be thinking, okay, this is cool. Two companies launching a similar product. Why should I care? Here's why this is huge. DJI controls somewhere between 70 or 85% of the US consumer drone market. They are the absolute giants. Now, when somebody tries to compete with DJI, it never goes well. Sony tried with the AP, failed. GoPro tried with the Karma, failed. Sky Studio discontinued their consumer drones. Now, DJI has just about crushed and annihilated anybody that stood up to them. But Insta360, they're the one company that's actually given DJI a run for the money. Now, in the 360 camera space, the Insta360 X5 that just came out is beating DJI Osmo 360 in the market in every way possible. So when Insta360 says, hey, we're going to make a drone, people actually started paying attention. Now, second, this is genuinely a new category. This isn't just a slightly better specs or a new color here and there that we're talking about. This is a completely different way to capture drone footage. Shoot once, reframe in post. No more missing the shots. Immersive VR content that could happen and change how creators use drones instantly. Thirdly, this US ban situation adds a layer of urgency. If DJI can't launch their products after December 23rd, the Avata 360 could be their last new drone in America for God knows how long. So that kind of matters a lot. Okay, now let's break down both drones. And let's start with the Insta360's Antigravity A1, since they're launching first. Now let's talk about the core concept of the A1. The A1 is built around dual fisheye lenses, one on the top and one on the bottom. Now these capture everything in a 360 degree sphere at all times. The sky, the ground, the horizon, that guy over there, that bird flying up there. It captures everything. Then you can reframe to focus on whatever you want. You can create a tracking shot, a reverse shot, a sky shot, all from the same clip. Now we've got 8K 360 video at 30 frames per second or 5.7K at 60 frames per second. Now this drone is supposed to weigh in at 249 grams, just under the registration threshold, with up to 29 minutes claimed flight time. This should be awesome. Now we've got a 4.5 mile transmission range. Well, 4.35, we'll say it's half. We have vision goggles for immersive FPV flying, also with head tracking. We have motion-based grip controllers. You control the drone by tilting and moving the controller, not traditional joystick style. Here's what makes the A1 special. The cameras are always recording everything. It's just pure 360. There's no switching modes, no rotating gimbal. It's always captured in that 360. Simplicity means you literally cannot miss a single shot. If a bird flies past you, you've got it. Somebody walks up and gives you the finger from the ground, you've got it. The drone almost crashes, you've definitely got it. Now, the goggles are a huge part of this experience. You'll put them on and you can look around in a full 360 degrees while you're flying. Now, to me, this will probably be trippy as hell, but you can fly the drone forward while looking backwards. It's immersive and honestly, it kind of looks incredible. Downsides, the A1 has retractable landing gear because the cameras on the top and bottom, they'd probably scrape the ground otherwise. Now, this adds complexity and potential failure points. Also, because it's always shooting in 360, I wouldn't say that you could use it traditionally as an FPV racing drone. I'd say it's more built specifically for content creation. The price of this thing is estimated between $1,300 and $1,700 for the full kit with the goggles. Now, that's not terrible for what you're getting, but it's definitely premium. Now, the DJI Avata 360. Now, let me explain why this is huge. With the A1, you're locked into 360 mode. Now, with the Avata 360, you can choose. If you want that immersive 360 footage for the cinematic shot, then just rotate to 360 degrees. If you want that low latency FPV racing shot with the traditional forward facing view, well then, just rotate to FPV mode. It's two drones in one. Now for the key specs is that we have a dual 1.1 inch CMOS sensor for 8K 360 video at 50 frames per second. Also shoots in 4K at 120 frames in standard FPV mode. We have 38 megapixels panoramic still photographs. And check this, we're supposed to be getting a 38.67 watt hour battery. That's 26% bigger than the Avata 2, giving around 25 minutes of flight time. We've got 4 front-facing sensors with LiDAR, plus 2 side sensors for omnidirectional obstacle avoidance. We've got OcuSync 4.0 for up to 20 kilometers. That's 12.4 miles transmission range. It supposedly works with the DJI Goggles N3, the Goggles 3, and the RC Motion 3 controller, also the FPV controller 3. Now, it weighs around 377 grams. Now, some rumors say that it's under 250 grams, but that seems kind of unlikely with all this tech stored underneath the hood. And because the camera rotates, DJI doesn't need retractable landing gear. The camera just points forward when landing. saving the lenses from scrapes and scuffs. Now that's one less mechanical part to break on my half. Now I'd say the obstacle avoidance would also be insane. We have four front-facing sensors with LiDAR plus side sensors, so this thing can track fast cyclists, maybe even cars at high speed. Now the A1 has obstacle avoidance too, but DJI's system is more advanced based on the specs. Now the downside is it's heavier, coming in at 377 grams. Now this means that you'll need FAA registration in the US. Now the rotating mechanism does add some complexity, though DJI's gimbal tech is actually proven. And if you're only doing 360 content, the A1's pure approach might actually be simpler for you. Now, the price is leaked at around $1,000 for the Fly More combo. Now that's only $79 more than the current DJI Avata 2. Now, if this is accurate, DJI is seriously undercutting Insta360's rumored $1,300 price tag for the A1. So let's talk about what we're potentially seeing in the market right now. This is a sprint to get products certified and on the shelves before the door potentially slams shut. Now, why has Insta360 moved their launch date up? Well, Insta360 originally planned to launch the A1 in January, but with DJI scrambling to launch before December 23rd, Insta360 said, nope, we're going first. And they've moved their launch date to December the 4th. That's probably today, if not a couple of days ago, if you're watching this video right now. This is the first mover advantage warfare that we've ever came to see. Whoever launches first gets the early adapter money, the YouTube reviews and the hype. And if DJI does get banned, well then Insta360 might have a clear runway to take over the drone game. I'm not a lawyer or a policy expert, so I'm not going to speculate on whether the ban actually will happen, but the threat of it happening is absolutely shaping this entire launch timeline. So, who should buy which drone? Okay, if you're actually in the market for one of these, which one should you get? Buy the Insta360 Antigravity A1. If you want the simplest, purest 360 experience, you valued under 250 gram weight and no registration requirements, and you're primarily a content creator, you're not an FPV flyer or whatever. Well then you want the longest flight time, you like Insta360's editing software and the ecosystem. You're willing to pay around $1,300 to $1,700 for cutting edge innovation. But then I'd go for the Insta. Now, buy the Avata 360 if you want versatility, both 360 and traditional FPV in one drone. If you're already in the DJI ecosystem with goggles and controllers, if you want the best obstacle avoidance in the market and tracking, and if you value range, that 12.4 mile transmission is absolutely nuts. If you want higher frame rates at 8K over 50 frames per second or 4K over 120 frames per second. And also, if you want to save money, that $1,000 price tag is way more accessible than the $1,700 price tag. So what's my take on it? Well, if I had to pick one right now based purely on specs and price, I'd probably go for the Avata 360. The rotating camera just gives you so much more flexibility. The obstacle avoidance is better and the range is absolutely insane. And if the $1,000 price tag is real, it's almost half the cost of an A1. But what is important is that the A1 launches December 4th and the Avata 360, we just don't have an official date yet. Just before December 23rd, probably. So if you want to be the first, if you want a pure 360 experience, or if you don't want to gamble on the DJI's launch timing or ban situation, well then the A1 might be the right move for you. So here's what I'm watching over the next few weeks. Now, December 4th, Insta360 launches the Antigravity A1. We'll finally get official pricing, availability, and real-world reviews. I'll be covering that launch heavily on this channel, so be sure to check that out. Now, before December 23rd, DJI needs to launch the Avata 360 if they want it available in the US. Now, that could be literally any day now. And believe me, I'm pressing the refresh button on DJI's website constantly. Now, December 23rd, the FCC ban deadline. Either a US agency completes their security review and DJI gets cleared, or DJI gets added to the covered list and this whole landscape changes overnight. Now, January 2026, if DJI beats the deadline, we'll start seeing head-to-head comparison, real flight tests, and, well, we'll know which drone actually delivers on their promises. Now, this is a wild movement in the drone industry. Two companies launching nearly identical products at the same time. Both racing potential deadlines, both trying to create a completely different category of drone, and we're about to see how it all plays out in real time. Now, I'm here for this drama. What about you? Okay. Now that's everything I know about the DJI Avata 360 and the Insta360 A1 situation. As of right now, this is genuinely the most competitive launch I've ever seen in the drone space. So here's a quick question for you. Are you team Insta360 or are you team DJI? Are you going for pure 360 experience of the A1 or the versatility rotating camera of the Avata 360? Drop a comment below and let me know. I'm genuinely curious and I will get back to everybody. Also, if you found this helpful, hit that like button and smash subscribe. It really helps the algorithm push my videos to more people. I'm Adam from Drone Unlimited. You guys have been colorful and I hope to connect with you in the next video. Thank you so much for watching my video. And if you feel like you got any type of value whatsoever, can you please hit that like button and smash subscribe, as it really helps my channel grow. I'm Adam from Drone and Lens. You guys have been colorful, and I hope to see you in the next video.